Hey guys, how you guys doing there? This is Magnus talking, and you are watching part 11 of Let's Play Civilization 5, playing as Shaka of the Zulu Kingdom. Let us continue. So, yet again, we start off an episode at peace. I think I'm going to destroy the citadel. Japan basically stole my cotton, and I didn't want anything to do with that, so I just stole it back. Did have to sacrifice a great general for it, but I do have a quite nice amount of great generals right now, so I do feel a little bit safe. But that definitely pissed Japan off, and I'm sure there's going to be some sort of retaliation soon. I've decided to just build these two wonders right now. They've been standing there for way too long taunting me. I'm pretty surprised none of the other AIs have decided to build them yet. Also, Japan sniped World's Fair away from me by, like, I think 90 production. That's so fucking annoying. If I just spent one extra turn in Alundi going towards the World's Fair, I would have gotten it. But hey, that's how it goes. At least our science is looking somewhat decent, and we haven't even built a research lab yet, so I do believe we can do pretty decently on research. But you know, that's fun. It's no fun when you totally eclipse the AI in science anyway. We definitely want a castle right now. Even though castles are kind of expensive. Like, Japan is lurking outside our doorsteps, and we need Nobama to have a lot of defense strength. Also, I'm keeping these riflemen at the shores just to prevent any settlers from entering my lands. Yeah, and we have a new cargo ship. We should get the highest gold possibly. It actually wants me to trade with Sweden. I did that once before. It did not end well. So I will not do it again. I will trade with Dido. Might yield less gold, but fuck is it, is it more worth it. And we will have railroads pretty soon. I might build an additional worker just for that. Because God knows, railroads take a long time to build. She wants open borders, but I'm not sure if I want that with her. I don't see really any purpose in that, to be quite honest. Oh, so Sweden finally wants an embassy, do he? He definitely doesn't like me yet, but he might start liking me more soon. I definitely think Japan is the guy I want to go to war with first. I think I'll leave Sweden for later. But if I want to go to war with Japan, I'll need anti-aircraft guns and fighters. And once Japan gets their zeros, they're going to be an absolute pain in the ass to fight. Their unique unit has a bonus versus fighters, which is not nice. Columbo wants Pledge of Protection. Alright, that's an easy quest. That's just a click of a button. It doesn't yield much influence, though. Oh my god, did I just get uranium from Milan? Oh my god, are you kidding me right now? They actually got... That means someone just discovered uranium, since I was told that... I can't see it myself, but that might be a bug, actually. That might actually be a bug. Now that I think about it. I don't think you're supposed to be told that you have a uranium before you actually discover the tech for it. Which is funny. Alright, I'm gonna... queue up a... caravel, actually. Can I still build caravels? I might not be able to. No, I can't build any more caravels. Okay, sub then, it's gonna be. That is after I get the military academy, of course. So I'm gonna queue up a sub for exploration. Subs are pretty decent at exploring because they can go through ice tiles, which makes them really good at that. And I also have the exploration tree. And did I get the... I don't think I ever got the Great Lighthouse, but I definitely got the Colossus, which is nice. Alright, so I might get the Porcelain Tower. No one has built it yet, so I guess I could check the enemy city, so I have to do that on my turn, however. It's pretty laggy to try and do it on your own when it's not your turn. But yeah, I might need another worker, so I might just queue one up somewhere, because building these railroads are going to take a pretty long time. Alright, let's view the other cities, shall we? Let's view Carthage. What is she doing? She's building a carrier. Okay, wow, that bitch is... Yeah, and a great war bomber right here. So, at least she's not building the, building any of these ruins. I would love to get Neuschwanstein as well. Kremlin is also good, but I can't get it because it's an order. It has an order requirements. Well, that would actually be pretty sweet. Also, I should probably get a workboat in Bulawayo. Two workboats, actually. Three workboats, come to think of it. It has stopped growing completely. Maybe that's a mistake. I think it will start growing once I connect the fish on the oil. And a harbor would definitely be nice. Yeah, I need three workboats, actually, in the city. So once the workshop is complete, I should probably go for that. Yeah, everyone's starting to build aircraft right now. Peace treaty is expired, so that's a thing. We can build the workboats pretty quickly, though. Two turns. So we need three of those. Not more than that. Three is more than enough. Tourism is not going great. But I still think it's going okay. I probably can build a worker, and now I'm doing other things. Maybe Attila's court can grab a worker. Probably would be a good idea. Oh my god, did Japan just declare war in Sweden? Holy crap. Am I seeing this right? The best buds of this Let's Play, Japan and Sweden. They've been like so close this entire Let's Play, but I guess Gustavus Adolf has said some bad racist Asian joke or something like that at the World Congress, and Oda Nobunaga was like, ugh, kazo, so powerful in Asia. Alright, I know my Japanese is absolutely fabulous, I am well aware. Well, that's oh my god, I can trade with Carthage now. Well, I'm already trading with Carthage. Why am I building a workboat? What? Oh, I guess I queued up the wrong boat. Can... There's no way for me to get... Is there? Okay, I'm really curious to see this, actually. How the hell am I supposed to get in there? Here, maybe? Whoa, or maybe here? No? You know what? I'm gonna let it go all the way just because I'm curious. I was going to queue up a trade ship, but I guess I can do that here once I get the windmill. I guess I can queue up two trade cargoes in, or cargo ships in Laffy. That probably works. Because I really want a military academy in Unglubunglubunglubunglu. I build them at half speed, so that's cool. Or twice as quickly, I should say. I also have a lot of coal, which I can use for ironclads, if need be. But now that I have sub-second, I don't see the point in ironclads, unless I want to take coastal cities. And I actually kind of don't want to do that, so I'm good. Oh my god, Napoleon just got completely wiped out. When did that happen? Yep, he's no longer on the scoreboard. And then we were four. I am actually the lowest ranked, but that doesn't necessarily say much. Especially considering I'm playing against immortal computers. Seriously, how am I supposed to get in here? I have no idea. This has to be an inland sea, unless there's a lot of ocean here. I can't imagine it being possible for me to get in here. But I'm just gonna let that workboat sail over there and see for myself. I guess I could send my frigates out to explore. I mean, I actually kinda want to. Because I want to find... I have a lot of quests to get natural... Okay, fuck it. I'm going to send my frigates out to explore. You know, I could probably sell some horses again. It's probably a good idea. Let's talk to Dido. Not sure if she still values them. Hello.
Dumb.
You want horses? I know you... Oh, I don't have a declaration of friendship with her. Is that impossible now?
Halak.
Yeah, she's happy to accept.
Halak.
So do you... You value... What? She doesn't want horses anymore? Oh, women. She doesn't even want iron. But she has 8 uranium. Oh, she's... I think Dido is the final boss of this game, guys. I am actually pretty sure she is. Alright, I think I'm gonna queue up a... fuck the stadium. I want a worker after this, because it's gonna take some time building these railroads. But Attila Court is gonna grow like fucking hell. I'm also gonna get the porcelain tower next turn, by the looks of it. I think I'll keep my cities in production for now. My low happiness won't really sustain much more growth, so I'm actually kind of happy with this. I'd rather produce buildings and structures quicker. I'll get more happiness structures. Probably a good idea. But yeah, what I love about subs is the fact that they don't cost any resources. They're relatively cheap to build, and they're extremely quick and really good to explore with. At the same time, they shut down naval units really hard. Once you get the nuclear submarines, like, it's GG for enemy battleships. As long as you got enough of those, you can kill anything, really. They're even decent against missile cruisers, because they got a ranged attack, so... So how are these guys doing? They're doing well. I would have wanted them to have more military, but... Suppose they got infantry now, actually. Oh my god, I'm really far behind on the military techs. Well, thank you. I got a great scientist out of that. That's pretty sweet. Now I suddenly have flights. Isn't that good? Alright, let's queue up two cargo ships and... What do we want in the city right here? Is it finally time... we want the granary, we want the city to grow a little bit, and then we definitely want the university. And once that is done, I think perhaps the seaport would work. Definitely. But yeah, holy shit, are we behind on military technologies. Oops. I'm sorry, guys, I lost something. Almost flipped my computer over as well. Alright, let's go grab that offshore platform. Yeah, Bolivia is growing now that we've connected some sea resources. I'm enjoying this little time of peace. Getting some time to get back on my feet and really work on my science. I say, and I am almost not building any science buildings, but shut up. You guys know what I mean. I'm just being Mangsy again. Yeah, this, I know Nobunaga is drooling on the city, but this time I'm going to be freaking prepared. I'm gonna have an arsenal in Nobama. I'm gonna have a freaking arsenal. And it's going to be amazing, and the city's going to have a million defense strength. And I'll have these Gatling guns, which will become machine guns soon, and I'll upgrade them. They'll be great. Fuck yeah. Oh, thanks for that. That's a lot of production. God, I love offshore platforms, they're really great. And I need all the oil I can get right now, because I plan on building a lot of fighters. Alright, you go work on the railroad. That's going to take a freaking long time to build. Holy crap. That is going to be one slow-ass railroad. I don't get anything that increases my worker speed, so this is going to be fun. How many times have we... Seriously, how many turns does it take to build an oil well? That takes a really long time. Holy crap. We're going to get a policy in 6 turns. That's probably just going to be another autocracy attendance. We can't get the really juicy ones until level 2. And then there's so many to pick between. You can pick that awesome one, which gives you tons of science and production. You can give the one which increases the production and science output of factories. You can get the one which gives you 100% increased strategic resources. You can pick the best one, which is, in my opinion, the one that gives 2 happiness from every armory and military academy, which is just insane. Alright, what do we want in Bulawayo right now? Probably a harbor. Lighthouse will also give us happiness, so I think definitely lighthouse. And then a harbor. And then we can probably go for university. Alright, this workbot is done. Let's send it up to Nobama. Our cargo ship is done. Is it worth trading from this city? We could trade with Carthage for 19 gold per turn. I think that's actually pretty decent. Like, I'd prefer to have as many trade routes with Dido as possible. And with 2 different cities, I can get that more easily. I'd rather trade a worse trade route with Dido than one who is just going to get eliminated as soon as Gustavus Adolphus decides he's bored and attacks me, like he tends to do. Oh, he's actually, you know, sort of... Okay, first things first, does he value horses? He does. Does he value iron? He does not. So how about 8 horses, gems and cotton for marble, salt, and a little bit of gold? Jag måste avböja. Okay, this is not to his liking, I see. You know what, fuck happiness then. Can I get 19 gold for this? 15 gold? Jag måste avböja. 14? Come on, this is a good deal. Ah, okay, that's good. Well, giving him horses essentially mean I'm giving him more hakapalitas, but they aren't really as strong anymore, and they can't really upgrade to anything more powerful. I think they upgrade into anti-tank guns, which... I've always considered to be an extremely weak unit. I don't build tanks. I think tanks are extremely weak because they are so massively outshined by the mechanized infantry, which comes really short after. which are both stronger and faster. You got the modern armor, but they require aluminium, and you really need your aluminium for your rocket artillery. Like, the modern armor are strong and all that, but I don't think they justify costing aluminium. I can understand why they cost aluminium, but that's sadly what makes them so bad. Okay. Cultural landmarks. I'm for this. I like how we're only, we're actually only offering one proposal right now, because there's only four leaders left in the world, so there's no more two proposals. There are simply not enough delegates left in the world to warrant. I wonder if you actually get tree proposal if you or tree proposals if you have a lot of AIs. I never tried to play with more than 10. I knew it. This workboat is not going to be able to reach this place. No, I don't know what he was thinking really, but I guess I don't want to have him sap my. They cost 4 gold per turn. Seriously, for one workboat? Holy crap, they're expensive. That's really expensive, I gotta say. Alright, we're working on them railroads, on them railroads, on them railroads. Choo-choo! Preparing for the inevitable war that is to come. I definitely wouldn't mind getting some more culture. But, yeah, I guess I could gather up the art, great works of art. I have a lot of dig sites, I have one here. I think, yeah, there's one here, so that's two. Also I can connect, yeah, there's another one there, three dig sites. I could actually get some decent, although with the historical landmark enabled, I should definitely get landmarks. Like, if you look at this academy, it's worth 2 culture right now, for example. I think Sweden has a landmark down here. Actually, doesn't he? I'm pretty sure he used to have. Yeah, so it's worth 9 culture. That's actually an insane amount. Alright. Cultural heritage, historical landmarks, what do we want to do right now? Scholars in residence is not interesting. This could be something. I mean, tourism is not really... nah. Natural heritage sites. That will give me 5 culture, actually, because I am working in Natural Wonder. Maybe I should go for that. Arts funding, science funding. World ideology, autocracy would be pretty cool. And I'm pretty sure Carthage and Japan would vote for that. I would love Manxism, but that would piss off Dido, and I don't want that. Yeah, I think I'm going to go for Natural Heritage sites. That's going to give me a 5 plus culture boost. I mean, there's nothing bad about that. It might give some of the other AI some increased culture as well, but I don't really care. I want more culture. I want more policies. So I'm probably going to build some landmarks. Is there any point to building this landmark? Yes, it is, because it's 3 tiles away from Luffy. So I should definitely build that. I can take this one as well. So I'm actually going to construct myself some archaeologists, I think. Maybe from Attila's court. Oh crap, I'm in the negative happiness area again. Well, I'm building a stadium, so that will be fixed shortly. As well as the lighthouse, which also gives happiness. We got one here as well. Oh my god, we should probably build these pretty soon, shouldn't we? You probably should. Alright, we're not going to make the archaeologists here though, that's for sure. We're going to build ourselves an arsenal here. And we're going to keep trading with Dido. That's awesome. So now we're getting 104 gold per turn. Oh my god, Dido's completed the Manhattan Project. Scary shit right there, I gotta say. Pretty scary shits. So how are we on the tech tree right now? We have currently researched, we're working on ballistics. We should probably get replaceable parts. Requires freedom. I don't have freedom, I think. Going for plastics would probably be the next best thing right now. And then we could... combustion isn't really all that important for me, I feel. Pentagon, however, would be a wonderful wonder to get. I'm probably going to go for that after that. And I demand pearls. I'm probably going to take a look and see what I can buy right now. Can I get salt from Sweden? He's neutral.
Yes, sir.
But he's still insulting me. Oh my god, he wants 34 gold per turn for one luxury. That's not going to happen. I'm going to try Nobunaga, but he's hostile, so... He wants... Oh my god, you got to be fucking kidding me, Japan. What the fuck? Are you kidding me right now? That's not happening. I'm sorry. I could ally myself with another city-state. There might be someone with a gold request. And there is. Cultured one. They only have a quest to give them gold. Japan has 104 influence, so with the 40, that will put me at 100. So that will still not be enough, unless I dump even more ally into them. But they give me first, though, which will give me happiness. Is it worth to spend 1,500 gold to get these guys? I'll take them away from Japan, and I will get more culture. You know what? I think that's a good deal, actually. I'll be strengthening myself while weakening the position of my enemy. But are they in Japan territory? No, they're not. They're in Swedish territory, which is scary as well. Sweden might attempt to take them out, but you know what? Fuck it. So I still need 23 influence, so I'll need to do this. They want you to support... Ah, I can give them units. Oh my god, but... Oh! Wait a minute. Pledge to protect. Please, Sweden, do not attack them any further. I'm actually gonna see if they wanna make peace with them. Is that... What was the name of that again? Bogota? I just fueled a lot of money into a dying city-state. I need to make sure he declares peace with Bogota. 16 gold per turn, iron and oil. It's very expensive, the city-states, but if Sweden destroys it, then that 1,500 gold would have been completely wasted. Also, I'm going to give them some units because they want that, but I'm not going to give them one of my precious riflemen with the unique upgrades. I'm going to give them some regular ones instead. This one, for example. So, just to get a little bit of extra influence and also to protect them a little bit more. So that's going to give me a lot of positive influence with them right now. I do believe you get a lot from that. That was just a quest, so that gave me 40 influence with them, I think. All right, we have a policy. I gotta admit that it's very tempting to get merchant navy. There's a lot of good tax here, which I would actually kind of like, but no. It's going to be autocracy. Alright, we're going for happiness next time, so we can go for elite forces, which I think is very good. You don't really... It's not a fun tenant to pick, because it doesn't really benefit you right away. But I definitely think it's cool to have. Also, I really want Bogota to repair this the first. Like, when you pay someone to declare peace on a city-state, or does that mean they actually sign a peace treaty with them, or can they just declare war the next turn? Yeah, I'm definitely gonna send these guys some riflemen. I think that's a very good idea. Just as I fortified this city-state. They actually got a lot of troops right now. Like, not a huge amount, but still, troops nevertheless. Alright, Olinda's gonna get Big Ben. I think I'm gonna get that, actually. I don't think there's anyone else who has actually picked Commerce, so... Crab from Dido ended. No, Dido lost my crabs. I'm a little kid, and I know it. But I'm gonna buy that. Definitely don't want to be unhappy. And when I have all this gold, I might as well put it to use, right? Alright, we're producing submarines, guys. We got the workboats improved. Everything's going pretty well right now. It's just a matter of strengthening our position before the inevitable shitstorm occurs. There's going to be a war, and it's going to be fucking bloody. And Japan, once I get a lot of artillery, I think... What I want now is research labs, and then I'm probably going to go into high-speed military production. And I'm going to attack Japan. I might take over the city-states that are allied with them. I might do that, or I might try to steal them before I go to war, so that I won't have to. We're definitely going to Tokyo. Like, if I can get the production in these two coastal cities up, that would definitely be nice, because that means I can get battleships in them. And having battleships in this little island sea right here, since I've seen Japanese ships, I know that his capital is probably connected to this ocean, which means I can attack it from the sea as well. Alright, now I really need to get a public school in the city. Alright, submarine, you are about to get a vision upgrade as well as a move upgrade. So now you are pretty darn good at exploring shits. And we can steal replaceable parts. Or should we steal radio? Which one is most expensive? Both of them are sort of good, but radio saves me an additional turn. Also unlocks some wonders, which I'm not sure has been sniped yet. Eiffel Tower seriously hasn't been built yet? Well, it's only a matter of time. Yeah, there's no way Eiffel Tower is going to be left unbuilt, so to say. We want a hydro plant, that's for sure. And is this stable actually worth it? I have two swords now, only one source of horses. That is not going to be worth it. And then probably some archaeologists, because I really want to improve those landmarks. My spies just revealed something to me, but I missed it. Might be that we have some intrigue to share. I'm going to go to each of the AIs and just ask them very briefly. Alright, stadium is done. I also think I'm going to build an archaeologist here, actually. I also need to improve this cotton. I'm not sure if I'm actually selling all my cotton, am I? If I am selling all my cotton, it's not really going to be worth it. I am selling all my cotton. And only two of them, so that means there might be another leader. I only have three guys to trade with right now. It's not really a busy game. It's going to be a busy game when the war breaks out. The inevitable world war. Fuck Sweden, man. I have a guy on counterintelligence. What the fuck is up with that? Alright, let's see if we can share intrigue. Yeah, we do have, Carthage is plotting against him. Can we share intrigue with Dido?
Dumb.
No. Can we share intrigue with Nobunaga? Oh, yes, we can. So we warned both of them. We got a little tiny diplomatic boost from that. Not a big one. Just a small little boost. Alright, will I have enough money to upgrade these machine guns? I hope so. I also need to build myself a lot of anti-aircraft guns. They're going to be very useful. Fighters too, of course. I'll build fighters. Am I seriously using oil? Okay, Japan, whatever. No, I just haven't connected the... What? I'm getting oil from here, right? For oil. What? Excuse me? Why do I only have two oil? Two total. What? Is it because I'm not working this? Yes, I am. Seriously, are you guys seeing this? I only have two oil, yet I have an oil well. I have an oil well. And I have an oil platform right here. I'm working it. So how does I only have two gold? What? That has to be a bug. Alright, time to choose a host. I can actually win this. I think Carthage win ties, but... Or is it a coin flip? I can't remember, but would it be kick-ass if I became the host? Alright, I'm gonna go and improve this. Then it's time to build public schools, I think, in Luffy. And in every other city that hasn't built a public school yet. Definitely about time I get the science rolling. It's been way too long. Culture is looking pretty decent now. It's going to be better once we get the landmarks improved. Oh, we should probably grab this antiquity site before someone else does. Do I have more slots for artifacts? I think I have one or two left. No, that's not the button you press. No, I don't. So I need to build something that gives me great workers of arch. What should that be? Well... I got Big Ben now. That's kick-ass. That is pretty kick-ass, actually. I like that. Ba 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 ba. Oh my god, I'm gonna need so much money once I get the replaceable parts. Carthage remains health. Yeah, the host win ties. Oh my god, it's lagging a lot right now. Alright, I have the Big Ben. That's pretty cool. That will give me a lot of different cool things. I can purchase things easier, I get a shit ton of golden culture, and I get great merchant points, which are all pretty darn decent. Alright, cargo ships, you are going not there, that's for sure. You're going to Gen. I'm not trading with you fuckers ever again. Forget about it. Okay. The frigates have reached their end point of what they can actually explore. It's only the sub that's left now that can go below the ice tiles. But yeah, I definitely want this cotton. Still so many Carthaginian ships. And what she wants. She is very chatty, by the way. Dido is the most chattiest AI in the game. She has a chat rating of H. It's a completely worthless stats, but it it's how talky they are, pretty much. Like when they say stuff to you and stuff like that. That's chattiness. We're not happy anymore. What the fuck? I don't like that. But yeah, I really want to grab this antiquities site. I can't build a landmark there, but I definitely want to grab it. I guess maybe I could build a heroic epic? I think that contains a slot for a great work of art. I think it does, actually. You know, that's a great work of... I need a amphitheater, and then an opera house, and then a museum. But maybe it's worth it? I think it is. Amphitheater. Yeah, I'll queue up an amphitheater in my city. It does me no harm to have a single museum. That's completely fine. Anyway, I'm gonna get myself another archaeologist in Attila's court. Alright, this frigate has also reached its endpoint of what it can explore, so let's send them back to the cities for a little bit of extra protection. I still don't like that I'm unhappy. I should probably try to do something about that, but what? I don't have any money. Kiev. Huh. They're allied with me. Interesting. How are my other city-states doing right now? Can't check just yet. Sydney actually wants me to give them a gift of gold. Bogota is doing fine. I'm still allied with them for the foreseeable future, unless a coup happens. Some of the city-states got really catchy music going on. Like some other civilizations. What the hell happened here? Oh. He stole the wheat tile, that fucker. Oh, it's not like I would have... Actually, would I have gotten that? One, two... Oh my god, what a fucker! In time, I would actually have gotten this... Oh my god, Japan, I'm so gonna steal that tile. I swear to god. He's a fucking asshole. Alright, do I want to keep sending food over to Nobama? I could send production over to Nobama. I think that would actually be much better. That would greatly speed up the building production. There we go. Didn't I trade with the city for a very long time? I think I did. Pretty sure I did. Dun 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 dun. Alright, a public school is going to be created. I'm also building one. No, I'm actually building a seaport in Lafay, but that's fine. I'm going to have my university done here, so I'm going to get two specialist slots. Do I want to send them? Or to assign the specialist slots? That's a little bit scary, actually. I might not be able... Well, do I really want my cities to grow? I don't think so. So I'm actually completely fine. But by God, I need a lot of gold. And I think I just need to build banks and stock exchanges in all my cities now. That might just be what I need to do. Yeah, I think we've reached a point where I need to do that. However, first, I was actually building a zoo in the city. I could probably complete that. It's like three turns. That's a no-brainer, really. Alright, I'm gonna grab a windmill in the city. You definitely want windmills. They're pretty good. No, I'm not gonna trade with you fuckers. Forget about it. It's not happening. Oh, Japan has been silent for quite some time now. I wonder what they're actually doing. They're probably up to no good. They're probably trying to make trouble in our neighborhood, that's for sure. Never trust the Japanese. Okay, that sounded very racist. I actually have a good friend who's Japanese, although he's a little bit of a douchebag sometimes. He plays Civilization 2. Not Civilization 2, like, is as in 1, 2, 3. He plays... Well, I think he played Civilization 2 as well. He's quite the Civilization veteran, actually. Dun 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 rum bum ba la 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 ra da 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 da. But our culture is looking swagging right now. 125 per turn, and we haven't even gotten all the artifacts. I think I'm just gonna go and secure this artifact right here. Although I guess I don't need to do that with an archaeologist. I could do it with a rifleman instead. Do I have any idle riflemen? Yeah, I have this guy. I'm going to send him down here. Just put him on top of the artifact. Just make sure no other archaeologist comes and ninjas it. I do need another archaeologist, though. So I'm going to go for that. Oh my god, I'm going to need my research labs. I think first research labs and then banks and stock exchanges would probably be a good idea. In the large cities, of course. Ah, my weekly gold boosts. Maybe she wants 490. Come on, you agreed to 480 last time. Okay. Well, that certainly helps a lot with the upgrading. I kind of want, like, maybe I should try to aim for Pentagon before I actually start upgrading shit. I don't think I'm necessarily going to be able to get Pentagon. Especially not if I go plastics first. Nah, maybe not. But it would be pretty sweet, though. It's a really cool wonder. It saves you so much gold. Okay. Currently only great war bombers and triplanes available. Alright. Denunciation of me has kindly expired. Usually they're pretty good at renewing their denunciation, I gotta say. They don't hold back. They like their denouncing. Alright. This zoo is definitely going to help out in the happiness department, but I think I'm just going to be unhappy again once I... Do I actually get any pressure? No, I don't. There's no pressure. There's not a lot of culture spammers, really. Yeah, everyone's pretty happy. I mean, Sweden is getting minus 10, actually. Huh, interesting. That's kind of cool. Alright, what do we want here? Probably a public school? Yeah, I think so. A public school. We gotta get those guys up sooner or later. Alright, finally we got the cotton connected. I think I'm gonna go down here and start working on some railroads. Cargo ship can go trade. I wish there was a way to automate this. It really gets tedious. I mean, it's nowhere near as bad as it was in Civ Beyond Earth, but holy crap, that was tedious. Alright, I think this one's going to be a landmark for sure. Alright, do I want to upgrade my riflemen right now? I might have to. I'm going to have to upgrade them twice soon. That's going to be so freaking expensive. Ugh, I only have 60 gold per turn. That's not enough. I need more gold. I really, 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 really need more gold. It's gonna have to be banks and stock exchanges. This is really the only way to go. I don't mean to be presumptuous, but I believe... No, I don't want your coal. I want your pearls, actually. Oh my god, he's friendly? Are you freaking kidding me right now? Since when did he start liking me? He's been hating me all game. Well, Alright, well that's great. That means I'm going to get Wheel of the King Day in like a million cities, because I know a lot of my cities want pearls. But trading with Japan has currently been out of the question, really, so I'm happy about that. Huh, that's really great. Mombasa Billet, they're my friends. Fuck off. Whoa. Hello, friend? What? Since when did we become friends? I'm not giving him oil. Embassies, however, would be pretty good. Oh my god, we're actually becoming friends. The impossible is happening. Okay, what do we want right here? I need a factory. And after that, I need a public school. Also, I need to place... these specialist slots. I need all the science I can get. Like so. You gotta be a little bit careful, though, because once you place your citizens manually... It means that you're gonna get unemployed citizens if you're not careful. Oh my god, these borders are growing really quickly. Holy crap. Alright, we can get our first landmark, I think. Definitely. So that is going to be worth 9 culture. We definitely want to make sure we lock that. Just gotta wait. I pressed unturn. It's working it anyway, but I want to make sure it's always working it because I really want the culture. 9 culture is pretty insane for a tile yield, actually, when you think about it. can find historical landmarks for land. I really hope the natural heritage sites goes through as well. That will mean this wonder right here will be worth a lot. No, I'm not interested in giving you open borders, buddy. And especially not for a horse. I was like, hey, I brought you a horse. Do you like it? It can be yours if you allow all of my troops to pass through your borders. Look at the horse. Look how amazing it is. Come on. Vancouver, that's not one of mine, is it? No. Bogota, still not. I'm actually considering paying them money to improve the furs, because I need the furs. 200 gold to improve. To improve resource, why can't I do that? It has. What? Why can't I ask? Oh, I probably can't pay to repair pillaged tiles, only to improve them. Okay. That's probably why. Alright, what do we want here? We have the buildings we need, so I'm actually going to go for a stock exchange. That sounds like a really good idea indeed. Alright, got to remember to lock this tile, even though we are currently working it. I want to make sure we're always working it. Because culture is important. Also, there's another one here, which I... Alright, this city. Now I'm going to focus it on... I'm going to focus production to begin with. And once it has all the production buildings, I'm going to start building the other buildings. You can watch over this little dig site until I can actually bring an archaeologist over here. I need a museum first. Yeah, there comes the Eiffel Tower. I knew someone would snipe it eventually. That's like a wonder that always goes. I've never seen a game where nobody wants the Eiffel Tower. It's just that good. If Dido starts spamming a lot of tourism, she might actually become a problem. Not because she can't win a tourism victory anyway, but she can certainly pressure me heavily if she spams a lot of culture. I'm not getting any pressure right now, because actually Dido has autocracy, so that's no problem at all. Like, you only get pressure if another leader has a different ideology to you, and they have a lot of tourism. That's when you start getting unhappiness, because people see their wonderful country and they want yours to be just like that. You could kind of say, like, I guess you could use North Korea as a very good example of that, right? Take North Korea today, right? It's an absolute terrible place to live. Nobody wants to live there. The North Koreans, however, are not really aware of how good the rest of the world is compared to North Korea, because they're, you know, all brainwashed. But then tourists arrive and they actually manage to get their hands on media via tourism and other means, like the internets. And then they actually start to see, hey, these other countries are really good. They got food, they got houses, they got shelter. Why can't we have that? And as a result, the unhappiness of North Korea starts to increase, which I think it's pretty low already, to the point where a revolution takes place and the ideology gets changed and Kim Jong-un dies. I think that was a pretty fucking good representation of how tourism works in real life, actually. I didn't really think about that. I literally thought about that on the spot right now. And I think that's a really good example of what is happening in the world right now, and why tourism can actually win you the game. You know, why it's actually such an important deal. It's actually being said many times that you don't want to invade a country with machine guns. You want to invade them with pop music and miniskirts. You want to have your culture take over the country instead of the soldiers. And that's really the best way. And that also is actually represented by the fact that when you have complete dominance over someone culture-wise, if you actually attack their cities, they won't be in resistance. Isn't that genius? So it's actually pretty well thought of, this system. Like, many people have claimed it to be bullshit. Like, how can I win a game by building hotels? That doesn't make any sense. Well, actually, it makes a fuck ton of sense in today's world. So there you go, history lesson with Manx. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Okay, we're still unhappy. What the fuck? Okay, have a sou then. And then I want a bank. Why are you still unhappy? We need to nuke our own city. That would actually be hilarious. Alright, I'm gonna build a sou. And then I'm gonna work on the opera house, I think. Yeah, I need sous in all of my cities. Happiness first, then science, then gold. That's my priorities right now. And I'm not sure if I want to upgrade my soldiers. I kind of feel like I have to, or else a war will break out. But I don't want to spend my hard-earned gold. I really don't. The moment I get into positive happiness, one of my cities just go poop, gross, and then I'm unhappy again. Pretty much what happens. That's okay, I forgive you. I'm actually raking in the greens on Japan right now. But that's cool. Like, I love killing another spy. Not only does it level up my spy, but it also prevents the enemy from getting techs, and it gives you a diplomatic boost, which is a little bit silly, I gotta admit. I mean, you think they'd be angry for you killing their spy, not grateful. I am so glad you killed my spy. Now I want to be friends with you. Bogota electing shenanigans. Oh no. That's not good. Fucker! Ain't happening. I think Dido has patronage or something. They want us to connect marble. We can do that. No, she only has one copy left. Salt? I definitely want salt.
Dumb. Di Berta?
Maybe I can actually pay her flood gold.
Bye.
How much do you want? I kind of prefer that. Okay, 250. That's definitely a good deal. Sugar?
Oh.
9 gold for sugar? I think some of my cities want that, so that's actually great. I think still think Sweden hates me, though.
Yeah, so.
Nah, he doesn't even want to trade now. He hates me even more than before. Alright. Landmark improvement it is. Lock this. I'm getting it. Oh my god, that's such a nice boost to my culture. Holy crap. And now my happiness is actually looking good, but I still think I'll grab the tenant, which gives me happiness from armories and military academies, just because it's that good. It essentially means you can get like 6 extra happiness in every city, which is like, it's going to take care of all of your happiness issues. And hell, I might actually get a golden age soon. Yep, I might actually get a golden age soon. It's been a pretty long while since I've gotten a golden age. And I'm still going to let these 2s complete, because you know how this game works. You drop back into the negatives right away. Suddenly something happens, your people get pissed off, everyone gets sad and upset, and then, yeah, nobody's happy anymore. Oh my god, I couldn't. No, there's no point to improving this fish tile. It's too far away from the city to be worked. If it was one tile closer north, it would have been much easier, but no, that is not the case, sadly. Although, 1, 2, 3. I might get this fish tile if I purchase it. I think I will. I think I will. That might piss off Japan a little bit, but I still will do it. And I am going to be making myself a workboat and go and get that fish. Because fish is really, really fucking good. We like fish. Do we want another archaeologist or do we want something else right here now? Probably want a bank, don't we? We want a bank. We want them monies. Money, 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 money. Where are you going? Where's my previous routes? Oh, there it is, but another city has appeared that is much more favorable to trade with. I wish you could just set automate this trade route to target the city with the highest gold output, although in my case that would actually be a little bit bad. Alright, thank you for the landmark. Lock that tile. Currently getting 152 culture. Holy crap! This is some good efficient culture right here, I gotta say. Look at that. I am enjoying that. Keep the tenants rolling. That's all I can say. And I'm gonna get another landmark here. I could have gotten one here as well. I'm actually regretting that a little bit, I gotta say. Alundi is probably at a level where it can... Oh, I'm actually not working in the public school? That has to be a bug. I'm pretty sure I'm working the public school. I can also get myself a... Can I get myself some more great people for faith right now? I've currently been buying generals, but... Perhaps I should go for a great prophet instead. I could convert some of the city-states. Oh, my city-states have already converted these cities. I could try to get open borders with Stockholm, and I could... You know, that would be pretty cool.
Yeah,
so what would it take? There's no way to make this work. Oh my god, Manxism has actually reached Stockholm right now. Would it be kick-ass if I could get Bogota to convert, because that would mean my influence would fall slower. So I'm actually going to go do that. Influence degrades 50% slower when you have a religion shared with the city-state. It's not a bonus that appears, but it is very much intact, or very much in play. It's actually a pretty massive deal. And it's actually a fun fact. If you play as Alexander, which you know the Greek special little thing is that influence degrades 25% slower, I think. If you have patronage and a shared religion, as well as the Greek civilization bonus, your influence with city-states will actually degrade at a speed of zero. Which, you know, is pretty overpowered. It means you pretty much are their friends for life, unless somehow someone managed to get above you. But it's only going to be temporary in that case, because they are eventually going to drop down below you anyway. If anyone played Silver during Vanilla, they might remember the terrible patronage finisher, which was that everyone else influenced the grades 33% quicker. That was hilarious to get. That was such a hard... Like, when someone adopted patronage, it was always like, oh, fuck. No. Oh my god, my city-states. Oh wow, that's four cities who just got a We Love the King Day. I got 18 happiness, but it doesn't matter. My cities are going to grow so quickly now. Oh. Told you to go here. Don't need to say it again, do I? Alright, research labs incoming. This needs to be done. Alright. The railroads are being reconstructed. I suppose I can help out a little bit. That was a lot of cities who entered We Love the King Day. Holy crap. It's because Bogota just repaired this tile. You know, if Sweden actually attacks Bogota, I'm fucked. Maybe I should give them some units. I don't know. Might be a good idea. Right now, I need to worry about my units. I'm actually a little bit weak right now. I gotta say, I need to upgrade these things. But, money. I want my money. I still haven't upgraded this Impi. He's a relic of the past. Like this guy, he works at a shopping center. He walks around going like, "Oogla boogla boogla boogla. Look at me. I am a representative of our ancient culture." He's like a clown, pretty much. That's his job. This guy is Impus the Impi. And he just lost his job and got conscripted into the military. Oh my god, 130 gold. Are you kidding me right now? That's so much. That is so much. I don't want to pay that much. I want an ironworks. Okay. I have to go for the research lab. I really want the Crystal Redentor. Oh my god, I want that so bad. Okay, I'm gonna go for Crystal Redentor. Fuck it. I'm gonna go for Crystal Redentor. I don't care what people say. Alright, natural heritage site? Sure. World religion Buddhism, however. Fuck that shit. I'm gonna vote against Carthage. I don't want to do that. I trust that Sweden and Japan will take care of that for me. Surely they are not interested in that. Surely they are not. No, they are not. They do not want that religion. Sweden actually wants Manxism, because it's... That actually... That might give me a bonus with him. No. The knee. I think I need Manxism to actually be a thing in Stockholm. What? I'm trading with Stockholm? Must be a land trade route. Actually getting some decent pressure. Maybe if I could get the Grand Temple. Alright. You will pay for this. That's the bad thing about being allied with Bogota. It means Gustavus Adolphus can harass them and I will need to constantly ruin my diplomatic relations with him in order to maintain my relations with the city-state, but maybe I should just revoke the protection. The thing is, the protection also means he's reluctant to attack the city-states, because he knows it will piss me off, so it serves a purpose to have it there, but I also feel like it's also damaging a lot of my... I would like to build up a somewhat nice relationship, but... Now to think about it, now that I'm actually friendly with Japan, I might actually target Sweden instead. Because he's a bit of a douche, he's the only guy who won't talk to me. I don't know. But before I can do anything, I need to work on my science. All right. Do I want to go for autocracy as a world ideology? It's only really going to piss off Sweden, so hell, let's go for it. So, what passed? Was passed. Lovely. And the Buddhism was not passed. So now the Rock of Gibraltar is worth 5. Awesome. Look at my fucking culture. Oh my god. That is actually pretty fucking kick-ass, I gotta say. Again, would love for this to be automated. So yeah, culture is definitely not a problem anymore. Okay, I'm gonna play until I get another policy and then I'm going to end this part. I pretty much know what I'm gonna pick though. And if I get Christo Redentor on top of that, holy crap, that'd be great. My god, I'm playing the peaceful Zulus again. This is what happens when I start to escalate at 1 point. Don't worry guys, there will be wars, there will be bloody wars. There's the only way to win this game, so I can actually 100% guarantee you that this game will end in a war. There is no other way for this game to actually end. And I promise you guys, I know I've been promising this game after game after game, I promise you guys that I will nuke a city. I will nuke several cities, I will build nukes, and I will use them. Granted that I have uranium accessible, actually I will get uranium from Milan, so that shouldn't be a problem. Yes, I will nuke cities in this Let's Play. A lot. Because it comes to a point where I don't really give a fuck about... Oh my god, I can get Neuschwanstein. That is too good to pass up. I am definitely going to go for Neuschwanstein. And... a research lab, definitely. I guess I could just build that aqueduct really quickly. As well as the seaport to get the extra production from the sea resources. The seaport would actually be insane. It's almost too good not to build. Because it will give me 1 production and 1 gold. It will give me 4 production and 4 gold from these fish tiles, which will of course be multiplied by all the other modifiers in the city, which will then translate into a lot of shit, so. It's too good not to do, I feel. And Dido likes my proposal. Sweden is gonna be pissed off about it, but at this point, do we really care what Sweden thinks? I certainly don't. Right, he has a lot of aircraft, though. Me, I'm Gustavus Adolfus. I don't like anyone. It's funny, though, because Gustavus Adolfus is actually quite a polite leader. He doesn't like to denounce a lot. And he's very loyal. And he's not deceptive. He's just really fucking aggressive. Yeah, Neuschwanstein, while it will take some time to build, I still think it's pretty good. I might actually ferry production to the city so I can get Neuschwanstein because it is a really good wonder to have. The extra golden culture it yields is really great. Besides, I'm already getting happiness from castles, so there is a point to building castles. So yeah, I might actually ferry some production over to Lothi just to speed this up. Someone else might snipe it. I actually don't know. Maybe, baby. I can take your maybe. Tell me, girl, what should I do? Oh, that was a terrible song. Alright, policy time, and then we're gonna end the parch. This is the one I was talking about, militarism. I have a lot of happiness right now, though, but I would like more. But there's so many good ones here. Reduces unit gold maintenance. Oh, that'd be fucking sweet. Oh my god, I'm paying 152 cash in unit maintenance. Quantity of strategic resources is increased by 100%, and plus 5 food and plus 5 science in the capital is insane. Total war is insane. Oh, there's so many good ones here. Oh, which should I... This is insane. If you want happiness and you're starting to go on the aggressive. And of course, lightning warfare. Amazing. Amazing with giant death robots. You saw that in my first game with Arabia. I think that right now, plus 5 food and plus 5 science in the capital is definitely what I need. I have 16 happiness. I'm going to get more tenants, so we're going to pick this. This is going to cause Alundi to grow at such a huge rate. I mean, look at this shit. I could probably assign some specialists at this point, but I think I'd rather work tiles. Yeah, I mean, if I somehow put this city to food focus, it's going to grow in like 2 turns. But Christo Redentor is also going to take a very long time, so I think I'll swap that around so I can complete that in 12 turns. Anyway, I think I'm going to end this part right now. When we come back, we shall attempt to finish off the research labs in all of our cities. Then we need to work on gold, and then begins the massive gearing up for a gigantic war that is sure to shake the foundations of the world. I'm also really curious to find out if I got any uranium on my tiles, although I know for sure that I will get it from Milan. Because I did get a message displaying they have uranium, so that's great. So yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying this patch. Please give it a like if you do, and as always, I'll see you next time. Goodbye.